If you were at the march, we appreciate you being there. I will, it's the first time I can actually say that a picture is worth a thousand words. So this will be the shortest speech I think I've ever given. And none of my wife's going to be thankful for that. Yes, it's a somber time, and we want to do something with the Museum of Fine Art that I wanted to show people for at least another month or so, instead of just hearing people speak and seeing some flags. You can actually have something to rip you from within. There's so many people affected, so many things to talk about, that I'm going to try to condense it as much as possible. I too spoke with Ben Steele Friday, and it was very tough for me to speak with him because I was a military survival instructor in the Air Force, and I'm a big time POW MIA advocate. I went through the SEER training, survival, escape, resistance, education. In other words, I spent 2 days in a mock concentration camp. It was the worst 2 days of my life. You learn a lot, and you think about it, if you've ever speak in front of you, and just to know that less than 2 days, whether you stand with a hood over your head or whatever they try to do to train you, it doesn't mean anything until you turn around and look at the flag. It instills something in you. But when you're a person who can go through 3+ years of sitting in the sun, no food, anything you can think of that could demoralize somebody, put somebody through hell, for 3 years of it. And I'm not here to be funny. I usually like to throw jokes in. I'm not going to do it this time. I had a couple in mind, but it's an amazing thing. So the way to summarize this is first of all, look at the pictures. These are not somebody, these are someone who took a piece of charcoal out of a fire when they were at dysentery, malaria, you name it, he had everything. And he sketched it on the concrete. And within memory, a lot of artists, people don't understand artists, portray themselves. And a lot of artists don't speak a lot. I noticed that. You know, they express themselves through their art. So to save more minutes of me talking, there's a book out front. I read it. I don't read books too often. And it's the best book I've ever written. I did not write this. I'm really nervous at the table. Tears in the Darkness. This is a New York Times bestseller. It's $18 up front. And I guarantee you, not only is it just for the Time Death March, but this is an expression of what someone and some people actually went through. I'm going to read a very few sentences that just sum up. For the first 4 months of 1942, American, Filipino, and Japanese soldiers fought America's first major land battle of World War II. The battle for the tiny Philippine Peninsula, Bataan. It ended with the single largest defeat in American military history. This was only the beginning. Until the Japanese surrendered in August 1945, the prisoners of war suffered 41 months of unparalleled cruelty and savagery. The way this was done, a lot of people figure out how can someone do this. First, you have to be desensitized. And that's what happens in a lot of militaries. They break you down as a person, as a lion, and having a heart, basically. And that's how people can commit atrocities. The way this happened, the Japanese in their basic military training were actually beaten down. And they had nonstop psychological abuse from their own Japanese troops in the Imperial Army boot camps. They melted men down, literally, up in here, and remained as unquestioningly obedient killers. And what I mean by obedient is you didn't have to ask them. If the Bataan Death March people were straggling, they caught a bayonet through their heart or wherever. With no second thought, nothing whatsoever. Just that it was reactionary. You see a guy falling over, you don't help him, just stick him in the throat to the side of the road. Well, these pictures portray that. The lost humanity of these men, some of whom were irreparably traumatized by the grotesque acts they were forced to commit, led to the atrocities of the Bataan Death March. General Hawa was held responsible for war crimes, and he was executed shortly after this. If you're wondering why the Parks and Recreation Directors up here in the city of Brownsville is really big on this, it's because we want to do a Veterans Art Project with the Brownsville Museum of Fine Art. Marsha Seltzer came into my office one day. She had a book. And I heard her speak about it. And just something clicked. You know, just something amazing. And this is where it started. We had the first Bataan Death March, April 10th. And Manny Melgar, Manny, are you out here? Manny, can you step forward? Well, people fail to realize that thousands upon thousands of Filipinos were part of this march in their own country. They fought alongside the United States for this war. Manny Melgar from the Brownsville Filipino American Association, we really appreciate the food that you provided your kids. Give you a round of applause for that.
Thank you very much. We appreciate it. Okay.